there, thrill seekers! Are you ready to get crazy? Are you ready to get extreme? Are you ready to taste the real hardcore? We here at SCP Explained know that you love a little excitement in your life. You're the kind of stone-cold, solid-gold bad dude whose idea of a relaxing afternoon is a staring contest with SCP-173. And you're so tough, you're gonna make the peanut blink first. You're the kind of person who'd punch SCP-682 and make him apologize for grazing your fist. You wouldn't even back down from the Scarlet King himself, making the Monarch of Ultimate Despair say, "That's pretty cool, man. Respect." But if you want a genuine thrill ride, something that'll really put hair on your chest, you need to get your butt on a truly hardcore roller coaster. What? Too chicken? Afraid of a little motion sickness or something? Or maybe you've been freaked out by some of the so-called horrifying accidents that happened on roller coasters, like the 1972 Big Dipper disaster, or the 1986 Fantasyland Mindbender catastrophe. Get real. When has a little death scared anyone at the SCP Foundation? And besides, nothing is more awesome than an extreme roller coaster. And believe us, any other roller coaster will feel like kiddie stuff compared to the absolute beast that we're gonna tell you about today. If you're a roller coaster novice, maybe you should try something like the Takabisha over in the Fuji-Q Highland theme park in Japan. This baby boasts a 121-degree drop, famous for making people fall out of their seats. Or maybe you want to try something like Yukon Striker over in Canada. This widowmaker of a coaster has floorless seats, a 360-degree flip, 4 inversions, and a 75-meter drop. That's a little too tame for your taste? If you're feeling really brave, you can hop on the King De Ka over in the New Jersey Six Flags theme park. You'll get a super fast 90-degree climb followed by a bone-stripping 139-meter drop, a 129-foot camel hump, and a 270-degree spiral. Ha! That'll give you a healthy dose of vitamin G-force. Why are we telling you all about this? Because compared to SCP-2183, all those coasters are like riding a tricycle with stabilizers in your mom's backyard. There's no coaster more powerful, more thrilling, and more adrenaline-pumping than SCP-2183. Let's take a look at some of the specs. You can find this bad boy in an undisclosed location somewhere in Idaho. This ride is so hardcore, the Killjoys over at the SCP Foundation don't want you to ride it. But if the lamos over at the Foundation had their way, nobody would be having any fun. Am I right? Look at how they put the kibosh on the Carnival of Horrors, or as they call it, SCP-823. Anyone who wants to go on one of those rides will just have met the business end of a Foundation sniper rifle. And think about all the kids who've been deprived of the awesome childhood experience of Cragglewood Park, aka SCP-2571, because the Foundation party poopers decided to rain on everybody's parade. It's safe to say that if the Foundation wants to keep you away from it, you're gonna have a dope time with it. And the SCP-2183 roller coaster is no exception. They have the whole park blocked off and patrolled by at least 4 security guards at any given time. People who see this piece in action are given Class F amnestics, and they've spared no expense in suppressing anything about this coaster to end all coasters in the media. But trust us, getting a ride on this thing is totally more than worth getting on the SCP Foundation's bad side. That's right, this killer coaster has a max height of 37.2 meters and a max speed of almost 90 kilometers per hour. You can't drive that fast anywhere but the Autobahn over in Germany. Sure, it may technically be unfinished, but this bad boy still has a physical track length of 798.8 meters. You're probably wondering why we said physical there, right? That's because when it comes to SCP-2183, the real ride starts when the track comes to an end, baby. When the ride starts a rolling, it blasts down the normal tracks like a bullet. But when the track ends and the carts fire off, they don't fall. No way. The carts keep speeding mid-air, continuing on the intended track from the roller coaster's initial badass blueprints. But that doesn't mean this ride does everything by the books. SCP-2183 is a ride that knows how to party. There's never any predicting the exact ride length, because every time the carts fire off the uncompleted section of track, they take a totally different path back to the start. That makes SCP-2183 officially the most unpredictable roller coaster in the entire world. The shortest recorded length of the non-physical section of track is 1,080 meters. That's almost double the length of the physical track. And the maximum length of the non-physical portion of the track has been 5,460 meters, which is over twice the length of the Nagashima Spa Land Steel Dragon 2000, the longest roller coaster in the world. But we know what you adrenaline junkies are thinking. It ain't just the length that gets a major buff, it's also the height and speed. Top recorded heights on the mid-air tracks have been up to 100 meters, making it the fifth tallest roller coaster in the world. And speeds have reached a face-melting 180 kilometers an hour, making it the fourth fastest roller coaster in the world. But maybe like Shania Twain, that don't impress you much. We get it. You're probably thinking, fifth tallest? Fourth fastest? I thought you said this coaster was truly hardcore, SCP explained. But like a good coaster, that's just because we haven't hit you with the big twist yet. That twist being, everything we just told you only applies to when the carts are empty. When someone is actually on this absolute monster of a roller coaster, it starts to do things you wouldn't believe. For you to really understand just how off the rails crazy this train can go, we've got to tell you about D93730, also known as the Rider. When the Rider woke up that morning, neither he nor the Foundation researchers handling him knew he was going to become a legend. As far as D-classes go, this guy was actually pretty lucky, seeing that he'd been convicted of one of the less severe crimes that constitute D-class duty. He was actually part of a release program, allowing him to eventually exit the Foundation alive and return to a normal life after he'd been involved in a certain number of studies. It seemed like a pretty fair trade. However, this was a real pearls before swine situation. Any true coaster head would relish the opportunity to take a joyride on SCP-2183. It'd be the greatest honor of their lives. But for the Rider, all it was a source of sweaty palms and an increased heart rate. Ha! Talk about weak sauce, am I right? He had no idea he was in for the ride of his life, in what would be both the first and last human test of SCP-2183. They sat him down on one of the carts, strapped and buckled him in with the safety bar, and got that baby rolling. When the ride began, the carts took the normal path down the physical portion of the track. But as expected, things got crazy when the carts hit the anomalous portion. Though nobody expected just how crazy this ride would get, least of all our lucky little rider himself. Ha, if he could still talk, I'm sure he would have changed his tune by now. The rider's cart detached from the rest during the mid-air portion and took a sharp right, going off on its own adventure around the rest of the abandoned park. Everybody knew this was going to be something special, because even the Foundation squares had never seen a cart act like this before. It looped around the whole place several times before whizzing through the park like a cruise missile, weaving between rides, stalls, and concession stands with ease. It was traveling blink and you'll miss it fast. This thing wasn't just white-knuckle intense, it was broken-knuckle intense. The rest of the carts returned to the starting point again and came to a stop, but the rider wasn't getting off that easy. There's a reason we call SCP-2183 the most intense roller coaster in this crazy world of ours. The cart containing the rider went AWOL, heading north out of the park at high speeds, putting it on a disastrous collision course with a nearby town. Well, disastrous if you work for the SCP Foundation. Totally awesome for the rest of us. The thing about a ride on SCP-2183 is that you really get your money's worth. When people nicknamed this thing the Ride Never Ends, they don't just do that for fun. This ride literally never ends. Over the first few weeks of the rider's ride, the Foundation just tried to suppress news of sightings from spreading. Multiple people around the nearest Idaho towns reported seeing a flying roller coaster cart zipping around the sky. Thankfully for the killjoys of the world, that kind of thing is easily written off as a trick of the mind. But this didn't stop the rider's epic thrill ride from tearing it up all across Idaho. Over the next few months, this party train really hit the road. Metaphorically speaking, of course. This cart constantly remained 120 to 150 meters above the ground and kept traveling at consistent speeds of over 200 kilometers an hour. That makes it roughly tied for the second fastest roller coaster in the world. The people lucky enough to spot this bad boy in action reported that they heard a panicked, terrifying screaming coming from inside the cart as it passed. That's how you know that the rider was having a hell of a time in there. Real shame that anyone who spotted it got a big old dose of Class A amnestics from the Killjoy Brigade. Speaking of those squares, the SCP Foundation tried multiple times to stop the ride and save the rider from this awesome experience. They sent in helicopters and lowered ladders down to him, but the rider, perhaps finally appreciating what a gift he was given here, kept his arms fastened to his sides, his face forced into a permanent grimace. Nobody knew how he could still be alive, despite having no food or water in all this time. Ha! We can only guess it's because SCP-2183 is just that awesome. Anytime these Foundation dweebs try to get near the cart, it immediately undertook evasive maneuvers and got the hell out of there. Nobody could bring this ultimate ride to an end. In the end, the SCP Foundation proved they could take being anti-fun to straight-up military proportions. They approved firing a missile at this piece of Coaster Dream Tech, hoping to finally bring its awesomeness to an end. After making a valiant effort to avoid them, the missile eventually struck the cart. They thought the rider inside was dead, but the cart kept flying for another 4 years before finally crashing 34 kilometers from the rest of the ride, relatively unscathed, probably after crashing into one of those beefy Idaho pigeons. And as the Foundation would soon find out, the rider was still around too. He just wasn't in the cart anymore. Nope, he was suspended in the air in a seated position 124 meters above the crash carts. We call him the rider, because he's still riding to this very day. And if anyone comes within a 50 meter radius of him in any direction, he'll just fly away until he's alone again. We don't know about you, but we think the rider's whole permanent flying situation isn't a horrific purgatory of eternal torment if he's alive under his comatose state. It's actually the ultimate ride. And really, what more could you want out of life, right? Sometimes people working on the site see him sitting in the cars, often only for a split second. He's one with the coaster now. Total nirvana. Like we said before, kids, the ride never ends. Now go check out A Sea Snail's Fantasy, SCP-1867, A Gentleman, and SCP-5094, Miss J's WizKid Schoolhouse, for more interesting safe class SCPs. Totally radical!